I'm putting all my eggs in one basket. I'm betting everything I got on you. Mama, I'm giving all my love to one baby. Lord help me if my baby don't come through.
Me? You're asking me about my experience with love? No, you don't want me. You want me. Okay, take a seat. Excuse me, waiter, we're gonna be here a while. Can we get a biscotti? What is love to me? Love is like a gluten-free food, you know? Parents in movies are always telling us if we accept gluten-free, we're gonna feel better. We're gonna be happy. Gluten-free is inherently good for us. Our bodies need a lack of gluten. From a young age, everyone dreams of the day they can embrace gluten-free, but you know, sometimes, you know, it's just easier to live with the diarrhea because gluten gives you diarrhea.
My first love was Gwendolyn Goldenberg. I met her on a warm Tuesday, which I remember was odd because it was mid-December. I was 10 years old and loved her every day until I was 17. She was cool, aloof, but quirky. She would always let me sing to her. Terribly, might I add. I like that. After years of being friends and me building up our fantasy relationship together, she agreed to go on a date with me. I was a complete wreck. My stomach was in knots and I felt like I was on a rickety boat. First, we went to the movies. We saw The Grand Illusion. She had a thing for poetic French realist cinema and, by extension, so did I. After the movie, she insisted that we get food, so we had tacos. Then, we strolled through the park, lightly grazing each other, and then I turned to her, and in that exact moment, I looked her dead in the eyes. Our happy future together swept over mine. I gently pulled her hair behind her ear and opened my mouth, and then I projectile vomited all over her face.
I was happy to get the sickness out of my stomach. I just didn't expect to get it all over her chest.
My next would-be relationship was with Evian Waters. I met her at the library. She was 21. She was much older, sophisticated, and more mature than me, who was 19. I always made an effort to try and strike up a conversation with her, or at least make a passing comment like, "That looks like a tasty muffin." But I could tell she only saw me as a younger boy, like her brother or her family's new puppy. I knew that I had to change myself to become the intellectual, macho adult she was looking to finagle with. So for weeks I would go to the gym, read the books I should have read in high school, and got my hair cut like the trendiest Hollywood celebrity. When I returned to the library, a new, confident, better me, there she was, cozying up to a boy who looked no older than 13. Then there was Sybil Veritas. She was a handful and always seemed to be taking a handful of my heart and eating it with her daily breakfast. We were constantly laughing and flirting. Our biggest mutual interests were pornography and constant touching. We were a more natural duo than mucus and the common cold. Thing is, she was a free spirit, in tune with her sexuality, but not so kindred with mine. And although we often spoke about the bedroom, we never quite seemed to enjoy our time there. To her, I was sexually inadequate, my attempts to please her always ending with a better luck next time, like a lottery ticket. Despite my constant aggravation, I never wanted our time together to end. I was grateful to be with such an attractive girl, but never had I felt more emasculated than when I was with her. My wavering ego always led me to believe she was looking at other men, which wasn't completely untrue. You could say we had a relationship similar to a revolving door, which also works as a metaphor for her vagina. I guess besides my penchant for oddly named woman, I also tend to get involved with the wrong characters, one of them being myself. I guess I invested too much into my ideal romances that I was blinded by reality, constantly worrying, changing, or degrading myself just in case they were the one. What am I complaining about? 3 bad experiences, that's nothing. My biggest problem is girls, big deal. I can think of a million worse things, like passing a kidney stone, God forbid. I'm always too focused on moving forward in the relationship. The only problem with that mentality is that it only sets me up for relationships to move forward from.
when I'm alone with my fancies, I'll be with you, weaving romances, making believe they're true. Oh, give me lips for just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Oh, give me what you alone can give. I'll kiss the pillow dreamer.